another morning, we're back on the water. Now, if you'd watched the last video, you'll know that we were searching for all the pots after the storms. We've just got three to find. I'm going to go up to an area where there is, I believe they might have washed up to, or where they should have gone. And after that, we're going to head out, get this pot back down. This is the one that was smashed up, new bar in it, it's all fixed, ready to go. Only took 10 minutes to sort out, so that one's done. The other one is, that was all smashed up, I'm not going to recover that one. It's a very old pot, that, so no big loss. It's all been recycled. And we are going to check some pots out there while we're out there. All the ones that we found the other day and baited. So let's get out there and see what it's like. At the moment, it's a little bit foggy, but we should be right. It's not going to get any thicker. Right, well, we've just found these ones. A bit confused on these ones, which ones they are, because these aren't the ones we were looking for, but these are definitely ours. Unless they're a set that's been lifted and dropped. But we're going to hopefully check out what the damage is and see if there's any damage to them and move them into a position. Like I said, it's very difficult knowing where your pots are half the time, especially after they've been scattered everywhere with storms. So we're just trying to grab them all and regroup them now at the moment, and we're counting them up each day to see. But we're supposed to have three missing, but this looks like there's a couple of pots we were a bit whether we had two more or not at a certain area, and this could be them. Well, they seem to be coming up pretty straight, so it's almost here. It's here. Right to manage there. Hang on, I'll just push forward a little bit. Well, that's one back up. Trap's turned back on itself, so a lot of things probably would have got back through. Might have holes in it. That's definitely dragged though. You can see the base where the ropes are broken a bit. So anyway, that's intact, so that's good. That big pink one is still the one that's got me flummoxed at the moment. Where the heck is it? Because that's the one I would have expected to find. It's got a big enough bobber on it to be able to see it.
Yeah, that might have been the stamp. I've got to say, looking at all that messed up rope that we had.
I know.
The weed
around here. It might have been its downfall, but at the same time, all the big pink ones we found without any problem. They hardly moved. It was all the others that moved, so all the older pots moved. Here we go. But that makes sense, because the older ones might have been slightly lighter from hand hauling. When we started making the new ones for the winch, they were a little bit heavier. There you go. That one looks fine as well, so. Excellent. Right, I'm going to put you down. I'm just going to try these pots over. Get this crab out. If you want to go home, wherever that is. Off you go.
Mile that way.
It was weird that it went down deep and then suddenly it got shallow again where it's not supposed to. This is a pot we cut off yesterday, the good one that was still intact. Left it on a single rope. We're going to join it back up to this now and truce it back up so that they don't move, he says, after pot's moved. Then we're going to have a quick look over there in the rocks, because that's where those pots are still jammed. We're going to try and go in at low tide carefully. We just baited this and threw it here yesterday, just to get it out of the way. Come back to it today, sort it out. Wow, completely nothing. This is why we moved out of this area, because we never caught anything here. Right, we have to take the rope off and get those strong. Right, here we go. out a bit and I'll have to reverse probably. Am I close enough? I can't see it. Okay, go when you're ready. Right in there. That's what I was afraid of. Yeah, that might be one of them. Maybe the ropes are snagged on the rock. I don't know though, that's a bit... I don't know what that is, to be honest. Just keep an eye on the rocks, it's not pulling us too close to rocks and stuff. I'm gonna have to try and swing us sideways a bit. Where's the bunch of rope that we saw? Yeah, I can see that. That's the weed that we had. What we need to do is get the rope behind it, but you're going to have to do most of it because I'm going to put the engine into reverse. It holds us. Got that one. Right. Hold on, so I might have to pull this back a bit. Can you see where that pot goes? I wonder if you're able to get that on the front and pull it out. Don't pull us any harder. You can't pull us towards the rock. I don't reckon you need to get that. It's too jammed. It's locked in behind a rock, you see.
Just want to sit there.
Just let me think a minute. Front, please. See what's in front of us.
Yeah, we're all right.
Right, get ready to pull it. You ready?
Yeah.
Don't pull it yet. Now, pull it. Look, we've got them back, so let's get out of this cove. Just keep an eye out the front till I get clear of this area. Now you're on about next, eh? Clear. throw. Good. Job done.
Right, I'm just going to pull these.
Got it. We've just found the single heavy pot that we lost. Get on the winch as soon as you can, because I don't think you're going to have much rope on that. High tide, you wouldn't see that. That'll be under. Now this thing should have survived. I mean, the amount of rope this thing's got on it.
Yeah.
This thing would have just taken a trip. Been like, oh yeah, no problem guys. Few rocks and that.
Good.
I got
bouncing
this.
Bouncing along.
Bouncing along. It would have been crashing through rocks going, yeah, didn't hurt.
Yeah, that's right.
We'll find out though. Remember, this is a single pot in the storm. We weighted it. You wouldn't want to weight it any heavier, really. Not if you want to get it in the boat. Rolling the pot.
That survived just about to operate there and a break there. But that's the weight of it, I reckon. It's on that more than anything.
Another pot found. Only two to go now, or one set. Next bit of potting. We were doing a bit of fishing earlier, mackerel and that, but we didn't get any mackerel in that. So we got one. That's all right. That one's too small. Okay. Well, we got one. Yay! Soft shell. She'll be really soft, so be very careful. They go bright orange like that when they've changed their shell. The shell will be quite crispy. Yeah, she's not too bad actually, she's quite hard. But after they've changed their shell, they get a very bright orange. And they are very soft usually. But you can see, even with the little bit of weed that's sort of, well, that bit's loose. Even the weed that's grown on it, it takes a while for their shells to harden. It doesn't happen over a few days, it's like weeks. And then there's a lobster in there, but only a small one. There you go. Little lobster, one clawer. Probably had that one before, actually.
He's had a fight.
Yeah. Yep, he don't look like he was the winner.
No. Brave.
Got bait in that one still? When you say a little bit. Yeah, go on then, drop it. Anyway, we're going to lift our new pot up. It probably still smells of plastic, but and things it shouldn't smell of. But you never know. Come up quick because it's not very far down. That's surprising, isn't it? Right, there it is. Looks nice though, and then you. Hey, it's first lobster. Yep. It's only a tiddler, but it's his first lobster. That's all that counts. That's excellent.
Little baby.
First lobster of the new pot. Little baby one. Yeah, we're only just in the bay here. We're just soaking this pot. You need to soak it for a few days. Let that wood soak
look
up the water.
How his little antennae come out all curly.
All curled up, eh? Yeah. Yeah, and a spider crab. Right, we'll push it over this way a little bit more today, and then tomorrow we'll, I don't know, we'll make it up as we go tomorrow. Yeah, let it go there.
Excellent.
Finally, a pocket pot. Last pot of the day saves the day,
yeah.
And it's pocket pot.
Yeah. Look at it. Again. Like you say, it only catches one, but it's usually a good one.
I mean, if it's regular, you know.
Yeah.
Yep.
Super job.
Mm-hmm.
Or it'll go very close.
I reckon, John, there was one that was. There you go, legal. Pocket pot does it again.
All of our pots, and look, it's as you can walk out here.
We've done all the pots out to sea. We've had one lobster just on size, and we caught this one in that little pot just off the shore. There you go. There we go, all pots recovered, bar two. Well, four, because two are still wrapped up, obviously, in that set. But no, only two still missing or unaccounted for. And there's always a chance we'll still find them. They've got a decent set of bobbers nut on them, so we've just got to figure out which way they went, because we've tried to look the way we thought they'd go, but no luck yet. They might have gone a lot further than we think, so we might take a longer trip out, but we're not going to do it today. But all in all, we fared okay. We had some damage, we've got a couple still jammed out there, but everything's accounted for, apart from, like I say, those two. Right. I'm going to head back in.